West Michigan. This is Grand Tap Media Business TV. My name is Pamela Keim, your host. We are recording out of the Grand Castle Library, which is located inside the Grand Castle in Grandville, Michigan. It is the second largest castle on earth. We want to thank Roger Lucas, the designer and builder of the Grand Castle, for allowing us to record out here with WCET. I want to thank Brian behind the scenes there that's handling the camera. And we have a very special guest for you today. How many of you remember Brooke Shields, who did the Calvin Klein, Cindy Crawford? I grew up with Cheryl Teagues, and the other ones, I'm trying to think of the other. All right, let me try that one part again, okay? What is her name, the one that did a vacation? Christy Brinkley. Those are the, and I wanted to say Naomi Campbell, so I had a little bit of on that one. Okay, yeah. I'm just gonna go into, we have a very special guest, okay? Yep. All right, ready? Okay. All right. We have a very special guest for you today. I've been wanting to interview an agency like this because I feel like everything has changed and it's gonna be able to give people an opportunity maybe they never had before. Most of us grew up looking at these beautiful women such as Brooke Shields, Cindy Crawford, Christy Brinkley. Maybe we even go back to Twiggy. And we thought we had to have this image, and Naomi Campbell. And we thought we had to be tall, thin, beautiful. We would have never would have became a model. And today I'm going to have Vonda Poll-Hartung on the show, and she is part of, I'm going to say this right, Unique Models and Talent Agency. And she is the largest in West Michigan, and she's going to be here today to show you that you don't have to meet those criteria anymore, that everything has changed. So if you thought maybe you might like to try to be a model, she's the person you might want to reach out to. But I want to welcome to the show Vonda Poll-Hartung.
Hi!
Thank you so much for being here, and I am excited about talking about this because I grew up, we all in my generation grew up reading such things as 17, Glamour, Mademoiselle. And I think a lot of that has changed to the Kardashians, things of those reality shows. These, we call them the beautiful people.
Yeah.
They follow them on Instagram. We wanted to be like this. And I think we compared ourselves to the Sports Illustrated swimsuit. All of us used to share, look at that, you know, when it came in the magazine.
Yep.
I mean, in the mail. And you would understand that. But I want you to, I know you're here today because I reached out to you because I know by looking at what's out there and was seeing the ads today, everything has changed. And I think it's the greatest opportunity for people to maybe want to, maybe there's something unique about them. So I want you to talk about your agency and what your mission is and who you're looking for these days. But as a mom, you know, your daughter to try to get 20 influencers, I'm not saying it can't be done, but it's a lot of work.
Yeah, we don't require that and we don't look for that. I'm an in-person person. And so I want to meet you in person. I want to get a grasp for your personality. I don't want to see just pictures on Instagram. However, if you want to further your modeling career, you should get with an agency because they're working for you. And there are a lot of people that are Instagram models and that are getting work on their own and whatnot. But you don't have that, I don't want to say protection, but you don't always know where you're going. You know, we vet our clients and whatnot and watch out for our models.
Is there still a danger out there?
Yeah, absolutely.
I didn't even really. There is a danger of going onto a suit on a set that could be at, we might be at risk.
Not with us.
Right.
You know, not with us.
Well, no, I wouldn't think.
There are a lot of predators out there that are looking for Instagram models. Oh, I'm a photographer. Let me shoot you for free. And, you know, don't bring anyone with you. I mean, and girls are so desperate to be discovered and
right.
to hopefully get a break. Mm-hmm. That they go and they're jeopardizing their safety. Mm. And so, I mean, first of all, don't ever, 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 you know, go with something like that without bringing someone with you.
Yeah.
And make sure that you have someone that knows where you're at.
I'm going to stop. I'm just going to go a little bit over, okay? All right. Okay, let's talk about, do you still see body images, you know, women suffering from that with the modeling agency, even though it has changed a lot. Are you still seeing women coming to you trying to be, you know, still have that image of what they should be, or they're suffering from, you know, that maybe they're not getting work because they're not perfect. They're not getting job. What are you seeing when they come to you? Are they still psychologically? Because we all hope that they were miserable. You know, somebody's miserable, right? We always saw, I hope Brooke, she did have some issues. But we didn't learn a lot about this until later when people started writing books. But part of us would like, you know, I hope she has a miserable life because she's so beautiful. Are you still seeing girls that are suffering?
I think self-acceptance is such a big thing now at that. And our generation compared to this generation and how mothers are bringing up their daughters is different because how we grew up, it was the self-image was, you know, if we didn't look like that, we weren't good enough. Mm-hmm. And now mothers today are bringing up their daughters to, you are good enough for anything. And you can, if you dream it, you can do it. And I love that. I love that. So the switch within doing this for 30 years, the switch and the self-confidence that's coming with these girls. I mean, these girls come in, you know, plus size, and they have more confidence than, you know, a size zero girl who is maybe, you know.
Why is that? I think it's because they had to.
It's empowerment. Empowerment. It's their mothers. You know, when we were young, I saw my mother, you know, getting herself ready before my dad got home from work. Every day she would make sure she had her makeup on and she was ready for when my dad got home from work. And I think it's just that pivot in an evolution of self-empowerment, you know, in mothers empowering their daughters that you can. This isn't a man's world anymore. If you want to do this, you can do it. And giving them that self-confidence. We can't give something that we don't have.
Right.
And so, you know, to be able to give that self-confidence to my granddaughters and whatnot and let them know, no matter what size you are, I don't care what color, what size, what shape you are, you're smart and you're beautiful. And it may not be on the outside. It may be on the inside that you're beautiful.
That's true.
That confidence comes from that, from those mothers. And, you know, the millennials today, you know, they're, you know, talked about these kids these days. But I'm applauding that because these mothers are raising strong, strong, confident children.
Well, that's a good thing. Well, I was going to say, I think people told me that had beautiful family members, you know, I think you I wouldn't say average looking, but you weren't model, you know, there's that you had to actually work on your personality. You had to connect with people with your personality. You weren't. And sometimes you're able to go in the room and not have to do much. And I've noticed that when I used to hang out with people and then all of a sudden I get to know them. I'm like, you know, have you ever driven in a car with her? She doesn't have a lot to talk about. You know, she doesn't really engaging. And I was surprised by that. And I was surprised how they were able to get away with that. I'm like, your mom lets you just go and, you know, doesn't teach you how to engage and be actually interested in somebody else's life as opposed to your own. Are you not, when they come to you, do you coach them if they've just been this beautiful? Because you're going to have some beautiful girls that are going to come to you, correct?
Yeah.
I mean, you have to have.
Absolutely. I mean, the clients are looking for everything.
Right.
And that does include, obviously, 5'10" and beautiful. But it includes everything because beauty, you know, what is beauty? And so we do have workshops. We meet with each adult, if they're 18 and above, we meet with them one-on-one and do an interview with them and explain how things work. But we also, Mary, who works for me, is a union actress. And so there's a lot more video going on.
Well, is that okay? Is that the work?
So we do workshops. We do workshops to teach acting and just model basics. And we do that right at the agency. And so they can sign up for that if they want to learn.
How about commercials?
So video is with social media, whereas it used to be video was probably, 20% of what we did. Everything was print. And now in the last 10 years, it has switched to, it's flip-flopped. Because of social media, when companies can put videos, commercials on social media, basically free, and don't have to pay for the broadcast, don't have to pay,
right,
you know, for the usage fees and all that. Social media has just skyrocketed video. So
well, I've been part of it for a long time. Probably mm-hmm. since for the last, what, I've had my show for 4 years, but I saw the power of social media, and that's how I started.
Yeah.
I was just putting my show out there, being part of that. I wasn't part of I was on WCET, but you don't understand. I've been on three other stations now. I saw the power of how quickly you could pivot, you know, mm-hmm. and let's talk about that.
Yeah.
It pretty much, COVID shut you down.
Yeah.
All of us down.
Yeah.
And then you have all these models that, you know, what do? You go on a suit, you have to go on a set and do a, you know, you do this whole thing. And so how did you guys handle that? Because these are independent contractors.
Yeah. Yep.
Just share a little bit what you did. It was like, did you send out a letter and said, you know, hey, email?
Yep. So we totally shut down, like all of our, because when our clients shut down, we shut down as well. And thank goodness that they are independent contractors. And like I said, most of them have other jobs, other full-time jobs. So, but getting back after COVID, there were a lot of protocols that we had to put into place. And
are you back?
And we're back. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what are some of the, is it just people wear masks on them when they're doing the yep. shoot, or how's that all worked? It's yep. the same thing as you would see in a salon.
Yep. They have to sign a waiver before they go on set, that they haven't traveled and aren't have any symptoms. And, so it's been everyone for the most part, the makeup artists, they had to go through training on, you know,
is that still cool?
With brushes and whatnot.
I mean, have you seen like a all right. I just have to ask, cause we grew up on this. But the whole idea of before and those used to be huge back when I was a kid, you know, the before and after on the makeup. I mean, what is, you know, do you get to enjoy that? Go and get your one day, get your hair and makeup. That'd be like so cool for somebody like me.
Well, that's yeah, for a job, you know, yeah. it's a day of pampering for a lot of them because they're moms, right? Sure. A lot of the models are actually moms. And so when they get to work, they get to get paid $800. They get their hair and their makeup done. They have to go get their nails done. Mm-hmm. And so it's a day of pampering. You know, yeah. It's a day of pampering for them. And then they get paid $800 on top of it. So
I'm not seeing that too much. Maybe I'm in the wrong algorithms in my social media. I used to see a lot more of just about 4 or 5 years ago, you know, you did the compare before and after. I don't know if you see, you know, models coming in and they've done the whole hair and, you know, they've cut the hair.
Yeah.
And you have professionals looking at you saying, I mean, that's got to be like, can you see that we're female? That must be the coolest thing is somebody can look at you and know exactly what good size your hair should be, the length.
Yeah.
And how it should be. Kind of like when Farrah Fawcett came out, we all grew up watching her. I mean, you're a little bit younger than me. I'm you know, dated a little bit here. But the idea that they can see that, and I'm not, is that still the way it is? You take your models and they put them on and they're like, okay, we're gonna show you what we really want you to, you know what I'm saying? What we really can do with your hair.
The thing of it is that most of the stuff that we do is lifestyle. So they're not glammed up on set anymore. It's I know. I'm bursting all your bubbles, aren't I?
Yes.
It's
not,
I mean, it's lifestyle. So it's mom in the kitchen. It's mom in the kitchen emptying a dishwasher for a major brand.
I do see that.
It's all lifestyle.
It's kind of like I don't even pay attention to it much anymore. I see so many commercials like that. I don't even see that. So yeah, but I guess we're just old school. We just love that part of the magazine,
the glamour of it.
Well, they took you know how they did that back on Oprah.
Yeah.
Took your hair.
Yep.
And they cut it. And then all of a sudden you're like, oh my God, she looks 20 years younger.
Yeah.
And they just look at, they don't even see that.
Yep.
On that one.
Nope.
All right. So before we wrap this up, share with us one thing. What is the one thing that would surprise people at owning the modeling and talent agency? You know, I mean, what the one thing that people kind of, well, okay, a couple things. Let's share with everybody what you know, people don't realize. It looks all glamorous.
It looks all glamorous. It does. And people think it's just this big mecca in which we have a beautiful agency. And I'd love to have you come in sometime. But
yeah.
It's very stressful.
It's a model, right?
Yeah. It is. It's more, it's mental. It's mental.
Right.
People are like, oh, you modeled today, you know, poor you, you know, but it's sometimes 10, 15 hours on set And it's exhausting. It really is. It's exhausting.
Well, how do you not sweat? You, all this kind of stuff, you know, that goes on when I'm just even doing the show.
Lights and stuff, yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
These poor models have to be, and a lot of times they shoot their winter stuff in the summer or summer stuff in the winter. We all knew that.
Yep.
And they said, a lot of these models says, I'm on the beach and it's cold.
Right. You're freezing cold on the beach, or you're wearing full ski gear, you know, in 80 degree weather. So it's not the glamour. The behind the scenes is, it's rough.
Believe it or not, it's rough. Right?
It is.
$800 a day.
They earn their money. Let's just say that. They earn their money. It is, you know.
I would believe that. All right. I wanted to ask you, are you using social media to get more business, or people just come into you and they know who you are because you've been 35 years of a successful business? Do you have to use social media like all of us that do?
We do. We have social media. Obviously we don't really recruit off from that. We don't. It's word of mouth. Hey, I think my aunt has a great look, or hey, you should see my niece. You know, so it's our current models that refer people that they work with, family members and whatnot. So most of our new models come from referrals from people who already work with us.
Is people still looking? I know that you said it's changed a lot, but real quickly, being famous or real popular in West Michigan? I saw a couple like news reporters in there. Is that an avenue in which most of them take? Because they get a lot of work that way? Or they just, you know, I'm going to put myself out there if anything comes, but is it really a big demand that to have these famous people that to us are famous in West Michigan?
No.
No. No.
I mean, we've had people who have gone on, like Taylor Lautner started with us.
Really?
He did when he was 10 years old.
Oh,
yeah.
My gosh. Yeah. Do you have anybody else?
He's right here. We've got a lot of people who have worked, you know, in Europe and whatnot. And have gone to L.A. and I'm like Mama Bear, so to see them succeed and
that would
whatnot,
be fun, kind of, right?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. It's pretty awesome to be a part of that.
All right, now that let's just wrap this up, and I'm so glad to finally meet you. And I think, I don't know if model agencies are as we grew up with them, right? Everybody wanted to be in Ford model. Mm-hmm. You know, if you were a Ford model, that was a big deal.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and is that still?
It is.
It's still one of the people?
Yep.
All right.
That's bragging rights.
Yeah!
It is. It's bragging rights if you're a model with Ford. But, you know, to our defense, we get just as much work for them as Ford does.
And with social media, Instagram, I don't even know if LinkedIn is part of your, just the whole social media component of modeling today. I would feel that there's a lot of work out there. Mm-hmm. Would you not agree?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
All right. So anything else you want to share with everyone about your modeling agency, your unique modeling agency, and what they, you know, maybe they're looking out there kind of like, you know, should I submit? I mean, you know, maybe I should try
if
it.
If you're thinking about it and maybe I can do this, please submit. Please submit. Just go to our website, uniquemodelsandtalent.com. Fill it out and what's it going to hurt? Nobody's going to know, right?
Well,
except
yeah.
for us. So if you're thinking maybe I can do this, you probably can't.
Have you ever had to be mean to people? Cause you know, we always saw those TV series or something where, you know, women would say you have to have thick skin to be a model because you get criticized all the time. Is that still the norm?
No.
Isn't that
I don't think I've ever made anybody cry. I hope not.
Yeah, she probably sent somebody else. Well, if you were to be a model, the one thing people don't realize, it's hard work.
It is hard work.
Correct?
It is hard work, yep. So you have to have, you've got to get your sleep the night before because you've got to have literally your game face on. You know, you can't be partying the night before when you've got to be on set at 8 in the morning or whatever it may be. Because that's going to show. It's going to show.
Yeah.
If you've gotten in a fight with your, you know, with your significant other, you got to leave all that behind and put that face on because you're getting paid a large amount of money to advertise for that company, their product. And so they're paying you and they're relying on you and you're representing the agency. You know, they're a direct reflection of the agency. Every talent, every model that I send out, they're a direct reflection of the agency. And so I'm relying on them, you know, for our reputation of being on time. You know, you've got to be on time. You've got to make sure that you're map questing. Is that even a thing anymore?
No.
That you're GPSing. You know, you're finding out where you're going. You got to rely on construction. You know, there could be construction.
Oh, I know.
You can't be late. If you're 15 minutes late, all those people, the makeup artist, the director, the producer, the photographer, they're all waiting on you. And time is money.
Right.
Time is money in any business, but especially in our business. So you have to be reliable.
And I was late today because, you know, I had to run back home and grab something, and you were so patient. You made to be able to be errands. Now make sure I have all my questions asked here. Okay. I think I asked that, Christy Brinkley, and we talked about that, and then the demands. All right. Well, we're going to wrap this up. We want to thank Vonda Hartung from Unique Models and Talent Agency, the largest in West Michigan. She's been in the industry for 25 years. I want to thank you for being on the show. We'll probably have you back because I find it very fascinating. I think it's really exciting that things have really changed.
It is very exciting.
And with social media, it even brings it out too. But all right, before you leave, what do you think of the castle?
Oh my gosh, it is gorgeous here. This is my first time here.
You've driven by this thing and wondered what is this?
Yes, because we used to be actually located right on 44th, just east of Ivanrest. And so I always, being over here, I would see it driving down the highway. It's amazing here. Walking through the drawbridge and everything, it's just gorgeous.
How about having a set, you know, doing like a modeling thing here? You know, having people be on set here to take some pictures.
Oh my gosh.
You could put that on there.
It would be amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful. Anyways, we want to thank everyone. And then we are in the Grand Castle, and we will catch you next time on WCET, WKTV, and WGRTV. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.